Asanteni sana, tafadhali tuketi. Mr. Deputy President, leaders of majority, National Assembly and Senate, Cabinet Secretaries present, Senators, Members of Parliament, good morning. Hamjambo. Let me take this opportunity to welcome all of us to this retreat of both the executive and our members of the legislature. Karibuni sana to Naivasha. I came last evening. I thought we were going to have a bonfire, but I found many of you had already, I think you had other assignments. Anyway, so, but I want to say this is a very important retreat. It is the first retreat we are having combining both the members of the executive, ministers and cabinet secretaries and the principal secretaries together with our members of parliament. Last year, we had a similar retreat, but it was just for the executive, but we later had an engagement with different committees. So welcome to this very important occasion. And going into the future, we are going to have at least every year a meeting like this. And so that we can together look at where we are, where we need to go, and how we get there. I must say from the beginning that I am a very proud leader of this team. The last 1 year has seen us do very many things. And it has not happened because of myself and my deputy, or with the ministers alone, or with the members of parliament alone. We've done this together. And I want to appreciate the input, the contribution of each and every one of us to the place where we are today. I want to remind you, friends, that we have a historic opportunity to change our country. Many of you may not appreciate, because some of us are first-timers, and others do not have as much experience. I am among now the oldest people around here in terms of being around politics and leadership. I want to tell you from where I sit, we have a moment in history to unlock the potential that Kenya has always had and to take this country to the next level. I want to urge you that let us not waste this moment. It is a moment when we have a manifesto that I believe, if implemented, and when implemented, it can transform Kenya. We have the numbers, both in the Senate and in the National Assembly, to assist us to change Kenya. I want to urge you, I know there is always a temptation to do what politicians do, and that is to focus at the next election. I want to urge you, let's do what leaders would do. Let's focus at the transformation of our country, and let us focus at what contribution we can make to change the destiny of our country by focusing on the next generation. We are where we are today as a country because we have always made politically correct, convenient decisions. And the transformation of our country requires men and women who have the mettle to confront situations and to look at what is right, not what is popular or what is convenient. I promised you that I will lead from the front. And I will lead from the front so that we can change Kenya. When I said I am a man on a mission, I meant it. We have to change Kenya. We have to change Kenya. And if you had any doubt that Kenya is going to change, I want to tell you that you just need to be patient and watch this space. Kenya is going to change. I am very confident. I know sometimes some of us get discouraged. Some of us get anxious. Some of us panic because of exigencies of moments. I want to tell you that we are going to take Kenya to where we've always wanted Kenya to be. Many people across the globe believe in Kenya. We must not be the ones who do not believe in our country. There are many people who have confidence in Kenya. I have been to many fora where Kenya is held in very high esteem. We must not be the ones to undermine our own country. So let me persuade you, leaders, that we need to hem in, to forge together, to think about how we can succeed together. When we fashioned our manifesto, we were very clear about where we wanted to take Kenya. We were very clear about how to deliver on jobs. We were very clear on how we wanted to deliver on health. We were very clear on how we wanted to deliver on food security. And we went out to the people, and the people gave us the mandate against a very difficult political terrain. We must not let them down. We must stay focused and deliver on this commitment. Let me just tell you a couple of things, because this meeting is a meeting that is a continuation of the PG we had. So I don't want to prolong what I have to say. I also want to listen to what others have to say. And it is good that today we also have our CSS and PSS so that we can have a convergence of thinking. We will need to collectively You know, and I like what Kishunga said. There is no other government in parliament. It is our members of parliament. You are the government. So don't stop pointing at some government. There is no other government. You are the government. Yes, you are the government. So don't imagine that there is another government, I don't know where. We all went to the elections. We campaigned on the same podium. You heard me talk about housing. You heard me talk about universal health coverage. When it comes to implementation, sasa watu wanaanza ku sijui sasa unajua hiki kitu imekaa sijui namna gani. Sasa mlikuwa mnafikiri hiki kitu itafanyika namna gani? This is how it's going to happen. You know, when the rubber meets the road, don't start kusema ilikuwa ikaenda ikarudi, hapana. We stay the course. Let me just point to you some of the things that I think we should be coming as we progress. We brought proposals on many of the aspects that would go to implementing our plan. And I want to appreciate that Parliament has been instrumental in making sure that the proposals that have come from the executive, from the ministers and principal secretaries, as they tailor the programs that are necessary for us to implement the plan and proposing budgets for it, Parliament have done their bit, making sure that there are resources that are allocated for us to be able to implement the plan. One of the big successes that we have had is on matters food security. I think it is a big issue. We had a situation where we had a crisis, and the crisis was not limited to Kenya. The crisis was global because of what happened with conflicts around the globe, because of matters of climate change, because of the drought. We had a very we had a crisis in our hands. By God's grace, we got rain. We had a good plan. You people allocated money for fertilizer. The Ministry of Agriculture and all the other agencies helped in making sure that that fertilizer got where we wanted. And I can report to you that today we have a better harvest than we have ever had in the last 5 years. And we have today also upped our plan for next year to increase fertilizer that is available. I want to ask all of us here as leaders to look out, you know, you as members of parliament, look out, make sure that you work with the ministry to make sure that your constituents, your regions, your areas have access to subsidized fertilizer. We have standardized the cost of fertilizer as 2,500 for all fertilizers. Speak to Mithika Linturi, speak to his peers, speak to the cereals people, speak to all those, and make sure that they do what they must, coordinate with them so that you can get the right farm inputs in your areas. We are proposing to expand the coffee cherry fund. Again, in the supplementary estimates, we will be coming to Parliament to ask for some allocations. We are working on with Treasury on how that can be facilitated, because Kofi has had a very difficult time with the cartels and all the other characters in there, but I think it is taking a turn in the right direction. So we will be working with you to make sure that we settle that. Same thing to do with the tea and all the legislations that are on the pipeline, and also in the sugar sector. We have just disbursed the first 1.7 billion in the sugar sector. We are working on the reforms in that sector, and hopefully in a couple of months we will be able to have a new space for our sugar industry to flourish again. Also, as you've had me commit, we are working with the KCC. We will be coming to Parliament for another allocation of maybe about a billion shillings, just to make sure that our milk producers are paid on time. We have made a decision together with the stakeholders. I had a long meeting with them in Nakuru, the milk processors. We have agreed that from 1st of March, we are going to pay milk farmers 50 shillings per litre. And we have also said that it will be paid on time. We are also working so that from the 1st of July, like happens elsewhere in the world, that farmers are paid every 15 days. Because those farmers who are doing commercial dairy deploy a lot of capital. So they need money regularly. So we are working with the industry so that we can deal with that. We are also working with development partners to enhance the capacity of our processors so that we can restructure our milk delivery so that we concentrate on two areas. We concentrate on supplying the lower market, and we have a big opportunity for export. It is a very positive thing that actually our milk products, the premium milk products, have markets globally, including in the US. So we have an opportunity to reconfigure that space, and we are working with the milk processors in that corner. We also will be coming to Parliament to ask you to, because we are working with some development partners, to see how we can resource the Agricultural Finance Corporation to give it more leverage to be able to support our farmers with affordable credit. I want to congratulate all of us that we have now the four pieces of legislation to underpin our universal health coverage. Congratulations to everybody. I know the ministry and the committee in Parliament and Parliament itself, you have done a phenomenal job, and I very sincerely appreciate. We are now working on the regulations, and we want to see whether we can conclude this. I don't know, Susan. I don't know if Susan is here. Okay. When do you think the regulations will be done, Bwana Pierce? When do you intend to table them in Parliament? So within 15 days or 10 days? 10 days. So the committee, the chair of the committee, health committee in parliament, I don't know, Mr. Daktari Bukose and my good brother there, Pato. So please coordinate, because those are very important instruments for us to be able to roll out the universal health coverage. Delegated, oh, it is delegated legislation. Okay, Mheshimiwa, more fire there, and Chepkonga and my good friend Gishimo. So please, let's see how we can accelerate that, because we made a commitment that the people, indigents, we're going to pay for indigents, the people who cannot afford, and then we are going to adjust the contribution framework so that everybody pays a commensurate or a proportional of their incomes. Let me also tell you that we were elected on a platform of creating jobs. It is important. And I have always made the argument that if we are spending, and you in parliament are the people who allocate money, we are spending 630, 650 billion every year for the education of our children, from nursery school to university. It will be irresponsible for us not to think about when these young people come out of university, college, and school, what happens to them. And that is why, for the first time, we have programs, deliberate, intentional, on creating jobs. It has never happened. You know, we keep talking, oh, you know, we want to grow the economy so that it creates jobs. But you see, it is possible for the economy to grow, but for there to be no jobs, unless it is done deliberately. And it is the reason why we intentionally put housing as one of the programs for us to deliver the transformation of Kenya and also create jobs. I don't think there is anybody who needs any persuasion anymore on housing. Do we still have anybody who still has any doubt? Surely. You have seen, for the places where the housing program has started, including my friend Simon Kingara in Ruiru, there is already a difference. It is reported by the media who has always problems with us, that crime in Ruiru has gone down because of the program we have. So there is a whole ecosystem of positive vibe when we implement the housing program. It will create jobs for us. I want to tell you, members, as we talk today, and Alice and Hinga are here, we have close to 130,000 people working in the housing program who were not working last year. That's what it is. Our plan is that by the end of this year, we will have a minimum of 300,000 young people working in our housing program. And it will continue to grow. So it is as deliberate as that. Do not, I know, you know, there are different ways of people how they want to profile and argue. I see many of you trying to still say, oh, you know, the levy. Forget about the levy. Let's discuss about the jobs. You know, the people who don't want the program will tell you about the levy. The people who want the program will tell you about the jobs, will tell you about making sure that we have decent households and making sure that we have new home owners. So I think we are past. In fact, the court said we had left out some people who were not paying the levy. And I said, oh, this is good news. Maybe we should go for those ones. So Murugara and team, make sure that everybody pays. And I'm happy that tomorrow in Parliament, we should be able to finalize in the National Assembly. Let us progress it to the Senate and let us get working. Let me tell you this. We will implement the housing program. I don't want to say by whatever means possible. I have just said we will implement. We will. Because it is what other progressive countries have done. It has worked. It is not an invention. It is what it is. You know? And even those who are opposed to the housing program, it is not because they don't know that it is the right thing. Their problem is that it is us who are implementing, not them. It is just as simple as that. That is their quarrel. In fact, when I had one of our friends say yesterday, when I don't know the day yesterday or the day before, that when he sees things, he feels like crying. It is true. Because they are now wondering, it was actually true that housing was possible, and we wasted time on reggae. You know? They feel like crying because they can actually see this housing was actually possible. So that's what it is. Many people thought it was not possible. They can now see that it is possible. I want to ask us here, especially our members of parliament, to pay very special attention to some of the things we are doing, because we are setting up the exam of 2027. So, muko na leakage ya exam. What you do with it is your problem. Because we are building markets in your constituencies. We have close to 500 markets. We have advertised maybe 200-300. They are in your constituencies. Go ahead. I have absolutely no problem with our members of parliament going to say, I am the one who has decided that this market be built here. I have no problem. Enda utangaze kabisa kutoka asubuhi mpaka jioni. Hata ufanye groundbreaking, I have no problem. And the layer. Yeah? Because this is your exam. This is a commitment we made to Mama Mboga, didn't we? Yes. We went to every forum. Mamboga tu, wakatuambia tunapigwa na jua, tuko na shida, tunapigwa na mvua, hatuna mahali choo, hatuna maji, hakuna stima, hakuna nini. So we now have an opportunity to do that. Don't let it happen without you. Wewe kazi yako ni kuinspect every week. Unatembea tembea kidogo, unapitia hapo, unasema sasa, unakuja unaongea hapo, unasema hii kazi kabisa. Eh? We have we have the county aggregation and industrial parks. Members, we have the county aggregation and industrial park. It is a partnership between the counties and the national government. You have a role to play. You know, make sure you go and inspect KAIP in your county. We have now five special economic zones, six actually, including one of the biggest here in Naivasha. In Naivasha, as we committed, we're going to have a huge industrial city here in Naivasha. We have just concluded the procurement and the purchase of 5,000 additional acres here. To Alice? Yes. Yes. 11,000 acres, but 6,000 will go towards resettlement of people. So we have, shortly, we will be now gazetting the necessary areas. And already, we have very many companies. I was in Dubai for the COP28, and we signed many agreements of people who want to come and set up here on account of our renewable energy, on account of what Kenya looks like going into the future. Take advantage and be part of it. And it speaks to the jobs element. We're not just doing this as structures. We are doing this because jobs is important. We have to be deliberate. I was in Muranga the other day, and I hope today, I told the governor of Muranga, between today and tomorrow, we already have finished the procurement of the first phase, which is going to cost us about 500 million, is going to begin. And we want to push this so that we have a good environment for us to create jobs. Further down, in our fifth pillar of the Kenya Kwanza Manifesto is the digital superhighway. It is one of the most important pillars of our manifesto. I have had a discussion with the committee, ICT committee in Parliament. I have had a conversation with the chair of the CDF committee. We have now changed the law. All of you know that. And I want to urge members here. Your first priority is to make sure that you are ahead of the game in making sure that we have ICT hubs in every ward in your constituencies. You have heard me say it, and I mean it. And many of you who have done a small thing out of it, you have known that you have seen the impact it has. Jameni, musifanye program hii ifaulu kwingine, and this is a program of your government. Because the people on the other side, sometimes they are ahead of us. They can see the opportunity clearer than we can. I want to urge every member of parliament here, listen to me, friends. You will create 1,000 jobs minimum in your constituency with the ICT hub. Munanielewa? We've just concluded, we had a thorough meeting with Owalo and many of the other actors on how to deploy internet, on how we have already allocated money for training, on how we are going to make sure that the place has power. It is up to you to make sure that you are ahead of the curve. So, members, I am talking to many people here. Mutapita mutiani, if you do what I'm telling you. Yeah? We are setting up the exam for 2027. So, mujipange. I also want to ask you, members, we have negotiated for opportunities for export of labor from Kenya. We advertised the other day for 2,500 nurses. Bore and Mwadime, how many nurses have we got so far? Imagine, we have only 500. And these are people who are going to earn 200,000 plus. Look here, guys, you know? Number one, it was advertised in the press, number one. Number two, Mimi, I have talked about this thing in every meeting, continuously. Sasa wewe, wakati unageti kwa hiyo mkutano hivi, unasikia president huyu anasema iko nurses. Wewe ujiulizi kwa kichwa hii nurses, ukitoka hapo kwa hiyo mkutano, si unaenda kutafuta mahali hiyo iko nurses, hawa nurses iko. Friends, because I still see people here saying, we are not aware. You are not aware. Sasa mnataka nifanya nini? Mnataka nisimame wapi? Nisimame, niweke volume kiasi gani? As we are talking today, listen, members of leaders, as we are talking today, Bore is here. Where is Mwadime? Or that other gentleman? Yes, that Mwadime is there, the PS concerned. We still need 2,000 nurses. Nabado. Just wait. Wacha tukukapa. Leteni kwanza tujaze ndio tuone. Eh? I'm just giving you the exam. Go look for, we have an intelligent person will live here and go and do what they must do. You have constituents. They will take a lot of offense if they discover that there are opportunities. Imetangazwa everywhere and nobody has come for them. That is not enough. We have 500,000, maybe 1,000,000 of such opportunities. Mnanielewa? It has to be deliberate. Somebody has to do some homework. I am trying to set up the bureaucracy. Tumepata tu challenge kidogo. We were to set up both the bureaucracy in NITA and in NEA to support you on making sure that you have as much information as possible. Because I have negotiated many opportunities for young people in Kenya. In fact, my Roslyn there just came back from Germany. We are almost concluding the agreement with the German government because they have asked us for 250,000 job opportunities. And they want us to conclude the agreement before June. Is that right, Roslyn? The same thing is going on with different countries. And it is important for me to talk to you, good people, so that you concentrate your energy in the right place. Unanielewa? Concentrate your energy as a people's representative. I thought we have so many people looking for jobs in our offices. Situko na wengi. There are so many. Sindio? So please, let us work together, because there are jobs out there. There are young people all over the place. We need to connect them to the opportunities. And please take what I am telling you seriously. You know, I am not talking politics. You know, kuna maneno tunaongeanga hewa. I am not talking hewa. I am talking to you reality. So, please, any serious leader will listen to what I am saying and do something about it. Tunaelewana? Because the only thing I find when I come to counties, watu wananiambia, oh, kuna mwanasiasa fulani, alianguka kura, tafutia kazi. Kuna mwingine hapo, alianguka kura, tafutia kazi. Na hawa wengine wote, amusemi. Na opportunity ndio hii, ina friends. I told you, we must work together to change Kenya. Please, tusaidiane kubadilisha Kenya. And it will take the effort of everybody. Because if we were to get 2,000 people, tukigawana hapa 2,000 people, sikila mtu atakuwa na watu ine ine, ama mbili. So, no? So? Sasa. Munataka tugawane hapa. Sasa niwaulize, nani alikatazwa kupeleka 20 ama 30? Ati amujaambiwa? Munataka kuambiwa na nani? Kwani amusomi gazeti? Na saa ile mimi naongea, munafikiri mimi naongea hewa? What are you, saa ile mimi naongea, nyinyi munasikianga, do you understand English or I mean, friends, I mean, wewe, waluke. Si mimi nilikuwa Bungoma. Ulisikia mimi nikisema huku sikia. Sasa, ulikuwa nafikiri, wewe, Murizania, you heard me, I was in your constituency. Nilisema ama sikusema. So, I mean, surely, friends, you know, tuwache hii maneno ya, you know, we like looking for excuses. Yes, wamaua. Si mimi nilikuwa Maragwa, my dear. Iyo maneno yote nimesema baba, si nilisema. In public, ukiwa hapo. Sasa, please. I have been, everywhere I have gone, I have not hidden. So anyway, I am not accusing anybody, but I am telling you guys, let us take our responsibility.